Hello everyone, I'm here to show you how you're going to be able to convert a mesh over to a point cloud. And this is a question that's come up a few times, and you may be wondering, why would you convert a mesh to a point cloud? Well, there's a couple of reasons why you might do so. I'm in a program here called 3DF Zephyr, and this is a photogrammetry program, and I had a small, just for fun, a little drone flight, and I created this mesh here. The mesh looks pretty clean, as you can see. Well, there's some artifacts here on the side, but if you just look at the path, which is really what I was interested in, and you get close, you can see that meshes make things pretty crisp and clean. But the source data for that is a point cloud, and if I get that back on here, I'll show you what that looks like here. Just give it a second. All right, so there's the point cloud now. And one thing you're going to find is with photogrammetry packages, if you use the point cloud that it first generates, and I'm just going to rotate around here, you'll see that there's quite a bit of noise. You'll see it's kind of fuzzy. And that's really typical of a lot of photogrammetry programs, especially where you have like a white color or flat colors and stuff. Now there's a bit of texture here with shading and stuff that it's able to do a pretty good job, but if you just use the point cloud, there's quite a bit of noise. So converting it to a mesh will clean it up, and then from the mesh you can convert it back to a point cloud. So next question, why would you convert it from mesh back to a point cloud? Well, the reason you would do that is for performance. So let me go into CloudCompare. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to turn on the mesh. So all I did was I took that mesh from before and I imported it. And I'm just rotating it around. Now, you'll see as I rotate around, I'm moving this quickly, it's kind of choppy. It's not really smooth. And part of the reason is that this particular mesh has got 1.4 million faces. Now, that's not too bad. Most programs will be able to handle that. But if you increase this to 4, 5, 6, 7, 10, 20 million, you're going to see a lot of these 3D programs are going to really slow down because they just can't handle that many surfaces, that many meshes, or small facets, if you want to call it that. One way to fix that is to convert it in CloudCompare. So if I uncheck this and I turn on the point cloud, now this has already been converted, and if you see I move this around, it's super smooth. Performance-wise, taking that mesh, converting it to a point cloud, some programs are better with handling point clouds than they are meshes. So how do we do this? Well, I'm going to shut this back off, go back into CloudCompare here, and again, this is the mesh, and all you have to do is make sure that you have the mesh selected. And up here there's a button, and you'll see it says sample points on a mesh. So I'm going to click on that. And I've already done this, but I'll try it again. And I'll choose a very low number. I had 10 million selected before. And what I'll do is I'll just check. Let's do a million. And I'll go OK. And I'm just using the default checkboxes there. I'm going to shut everything off. Now I'm left with a point cloud that is a million points, roughly a million points. So if you go and select this, you'll see down here I'm 999,595. So it did its best to get it about a million points. And you'll see that this point cloud now, actually let me turn on the previous one that I had because it was a little bit denser. If you look at this point cloud and you compare it to what I had shown you before, you'll see that it's a little bit cleaner, or actually a lot cleaner, because this came from a meshed surface. So if you compare this, and if I go back to 3DF Zephyr, which was the original point cloud, you'll see that this is a bit noisier. Okay, so a little bit more noise here. When you convert it to a mesh, it's going to clean it up, and then you can convert it back to a point cloud. The other thing that happens when you convert it to a point cloud is that it's going to sample the colors on the mesh as well. So if I go back to CloudCompare, the colors that we're getting here are not just the vertices, but also the filled in spaces between the vertices on the little patches. So it textures it, projects the proper images from the photographs that were taken, and you get some really good quality point clouds doing it this way. So really simple to convert this over. Just click on your mesh, and then just click on this button here, sample points on the mesh, and then you can choose how dense you want the point cloud. And that's about it. That's really all it takes.